Rico. You've grown up since last time I saw you.
Been liberated from Mirarello's troops. A great step toward freedom for all.
We'll be right back. 8:15. The president arrived today for his celebration. A few disobedient citizens protested near the port, cheering my name instead. I personally greeted him at the docks and graciously escorted him on a tour of our recent successes. General DeLuca's recent legal misfortunes still keep him away from public events.
All of this will be for nothing.
Day 816. Before boarding his ship to the capital, President Dante personally thanked me and intimated that the mess with DeLuca must be resolved quickly. The president promises to place it at the top of his agenda. Now, I must tread carefully here, yet ensure that it continues to remain a priority. Perhaps another embarrassment for DeLuca will tip the scales fully in my favor. Day 860. While I talk on the telephone, DeLuca barges into my office, boiling with rage. He thunders about my inefficacy as a commander, his own superiority, my pathetic pampering of our worthless president. After enduring 2 minutes of his tirade, I calmly hold up a single finger, return to the phone, and assure President Dante that I will call him later. DeLuca's face blooms purple as an eggplant, his fate sealed. Day 912. Surrounded by the beautiful countryside, accompanied by just the right amount of pomp and circumstance, President Dante swore me into the position of Brigadier General. Congratulating me, he whispered that I should rely on him. He knows the trials of being young and in power. I look forward to whispering back to him one day.
Brothers and sisters, Arco Esperanza has just said arrivederci to the forces of General Tiravello. The rebellion and Rico have done it again. Vive la revolución.
love it. And what do you know, that makes an even dozen carefully considered infrastructure improvements. Viva Medici!